What's the most wholesome thing a stranger has done for you? When I was working as a cashier, an older man pulled out a dollar and asked if I wanted to see something cool. Slightly skeptical, I said sure. He folded it into a little shoe and gave it to me, and it was the cutest thing. Then he told me, "Well, you can't just have one shoe." And folded another into a second shoe, and I still have them on my desk because I didn't have it in me to unfold them. The guy next to me on a plane once woke me up when the flight attendant came around with ice cream and got an ice cream so that I could have two. I'll never forget that man. I had just moved to a new town and had started a brand new job at a high school a few towns over. I lived 40 minutes away from my work, and it was the first day of school for students. I went to start my car that morning and it wouldn't turn on, the engine had died. I had no way of getting to work and I started to panic. I wanted to make a good impression at my new school, and it was my first professional job out of college. There was no way I would be able to find coverage in time, and it was the first day for students and a brand new job for me, not a good look if I didn't show up. I didn't know anyone yet to call, and this was before Uber was around. One of my new neighbors, who was retired and also up super early walking their dog, saw me outside of my car on the verge of a meltdown. They insisted on driving me to work that morning. They refused money for gas. They didn't let me feel guilty about the distance or the situation, and told me they were so happy to help BC they didn't have anything else going on that day. I was able to make it to my new job on time, and everything else fell into place that day. I later found out that they were actually in the middle of a big move and were in the process of moving across the country that week since they had just retired. I still get emotional thinking about that morning and the overabundance kindness shown to me that day. Not me, but my sister. She got severely sunburned while on holidays in Sri Lanka. We thought she was feeling better as she spent the whole previous day in bed. We went on a trip to a waterfall in the jungle. We were friends with locals who brought us. After swimming in the water, her skin starts burning to the point where she is in tears and won't let anyone touch her. We have nothing to help her. Maybe 5 minutes later, some local villagers appear with aloe vera plants and proceed to gently rub it onto her skin. Total strangers who saw the situation, went to their house and brought the aloe vera. It was so kind, I couldn't believe it. We ended up talking to them and they made us all dinner, which we ate together from a bucket in the middle of the jungle. Unforgettable. A guy in France, I asked for directions. Not only he walked me to the place, but he also kept me company and chatted while I visited it. He left after 15 minutes though, because he had an appointment. My senior year in high school, I stole my lunch every day. I was essentially on my own by then due to reasons and completely broke. I thought I was getting away with it for the entire year. Towards the end of the year, the dean called me into the office and explained that they knew I was stealing lunches the whole time. He then gave me a number to enter that would cover my meals. He told me not to worry about all the food, it was being covered by a faculty member. I never knew who it was exactly, but I suspect it was an elderly English teacher I had. She was always trying to sneakily give me cash and refused to let me deny. She even offered to loan me her new BMW when I made a comment about not having money for gas. I loved her. Edit, words. There's a spot in the building I work at that nobody wants to work in. It's the coldest area in the building because there's an opening that doesn't close and doesn't have heat, so you can't even eat food safely because the wind will blow it away. I was moved from where I usually am and wasn't prepared for how cold it would be there. I could barely handle money because my fingers felt frozen. A customer noticed how cold it was, and without even asking if I was cold, he took off his gloves and gave them to me. I have no idea what his name was, but it was the most thoughtful thing a complete stranger has ever done for me. I still have the gloves too. I was sitting alone at the cafeteria and a teacher came up to me and gave me food that she bought for me. I didn't know who she was, she has never taught me. I worked at a gas station at the time. I'd gotten myself a pretty large burn on one arm, helping someone lift a grill after it'd been used, and he dropped it without warning. A customer saw my arm, bought her stuff and came back 5 minutes later. She'd gotten me an aloe vera plant so I could break off pieces of it and rub on my burn. I thought that was pretty wholesome, smiley face. I was in Paris and got into a huge fight with someone I cared about. We bolted in different directions. I jumped on a crowded metro headed for my hotel and wept. Many people stared, but one dear woman fished a tissue out of her purse for me. It was really simple, but it meant a lot. When I was in my early 20s, I ran out of gas two blocks from a gas station and had no money. A man came up to my car with a jug of gas and filled my car for me. I asked him for a way to pay him back and he said, "I have a daughter your age and I know how hard it is. Merry Christmas." And he walked away. I will always remember this man. So nice, so giving. A stranger who used to be a customer at my job took me aside once and told me she has seen my journey over the years and is so proud of me. She started crying and gave me a hug. I wish I could tell her how much that meant to me. Many years ago, when my brother and I were traveling to Finland on a whim and most places were booked out, a Finnish student we encountered and asked for a youth hostel spontaneously let us sleep in her dorm's living room. For a few days, she even gave up her own dorm room for us and stayed at her estranged husband's place. She showed us around, bought us some typical Finnish food and sweets, and was just incredibly nice towards two naive foreigners. We stayed in contact for a bit until she went abroad, and sadly I never managed to find her again. This was before Facebook and she had a very common name. But I hope she knows how much I appreciated her kindness. In college, flying to visit my father for spring break. The airport was 45 minutes away from campus and I didn't have a car. After my ride left, the flight was delayed until the next day, and the airline said that because I lived nearby I didn't qualify for a hotel room for the night. A lovely couple gave me their hotel room voucher, as they decided to drive through the night instead. It helped me out when I was in a really tight spot. When I was around 17 I got in my first car accident. It was snowing and very icy, and I was driving home from work. It was evening, but still fairly light because the snow reflected a decent amount of light from the street lamps. I slid on the ice and lost some control of my car. I hit the one in front of me, not super hard, but enough to dent their back bumper and scratch my front bumper. Since it was my first accident, I sort of, uncontrollably panicked and started crying even though it wasn't that bad. We pulled over and put our lights on. An older couple, probably in their 60s, got out of the car and assessed the damage. I got out, crying and profusely apologizing. The wife immediately was like, "Oh honey, is this your first car accident?" and gave me a little half hug. She asked her husband to grab her purse and got me some tissues from it to wipe away my tears. She said it was no big deal at all, just some scratches. She understood it was a true accident and that I hadn't been driving recklessly. Even though I hit them and dented their car, they took care of me and I will never forget it. It's kind of fresh in my mind right now because my daughter is going through driver's training. Of course I hope she never gets in an accident, but if she does I hope she is lucky enough to receive the same understanding from someone. One guy in the Santa Claus costume came to me and gave me some sweets perfectly in the moment when I almost had a panic attack. We talked for like 15 minutes after that. This folk made my day. Helped me with my suitcases. I had moved to Sweden and was at a train station in Stockholm with two massive suitcases. The elevator was out of order, and I had to trek up a huge flight of stairs to get to my train. A lovely stranger saw me struggling, took my bags and hauled ass up the stairs. I was so thankful I nearly cried. Jet lag sucks. Years and years ago, this little kid walked up to me and gave me a little baggie of stuff that he was giving out to people as a doing nice things gesture. It was really sweet, and I still have it. Asked if I was okay, nearly cried. It was a tough time, but them asking that made me feel less alone and that someone cared enough to ask. I'm all right now, thankfully. I was at a concert a while back. I'm a very short guy and I was somewhere in the middle of the crowd windmilling the fuck out, not really caring about not being able to see, just enjoying the music etc. The guy standing next to me was an absolute giant of a man with hands as big as spades. Suddenly, he reaches out and takes me in his monster-sized mitts. I'm thinking the worst at this moment, maybe I pissed him off with my relentless windmilling, but he simply lifts me into the air and plops me onto his shoulders so I can watch the rest of the set with a premium view. When the set concluded, he let me down like a toddler and simply nodded at me when I thanked him. Edit, this really blew up? I am small, about 5'8 and 10 stone or something, but this guy was seriously gargantuan. He was an absolute hero and I always remember people like this in times of need to remind myself of all the good people out there. The band was Devil Driver. Windmilling means head banging in a circular fashion so your hair whips around like a windmill. The first time I had to move for college, I went to the nearest city and took a train that would have taken me to the city in which I was going to live. The train stopped halfway and wasn't going anywhere for the rest of the day, due to a strike. So I was stuck there. Some random guy then said to me, "Hey, my sister is coming in a minute, we are going back to city I was coming from, do you need a ride?" I accepted against better judgment, but he was really nice, didn't even ask me to pay for gas or anything like that, brought me back to the city and pointed me to some buses I could take. The hilarious part was calling my mom, telling her I was in some stranger's car about 3 hours after getting out of her house. I had a relationship go south and I ended up taking our 10-year anniversary trip to a foreign country alone. I met a local in one of the cities I stayed in and she hung out with me all day. Showed me the lay of the land, bought me a couple beers, and gave me a smooch at the end of the day. She was cool. My four kids, husband, and I were traveling to see family and stopped at a Red Robin for dinner. While waiting for a table, a gentleman next to us sneezed and I said bless you without thinking about it. We were shown our table shortly after and we ate our dinner. When the bill came, the waitress told us our bill had been paid for by someone who appreciated the blessing I gave him and wanted to give us one back. A year or two ago I was on a long road trip, doing about 90, on the highway. There was a guy behind me for at least 2 hours, not tailing me, but we were both going about the same speed. Out of nowhere he speeds up like crazy, cuts me off and then slows down to the speed limit right in front of me. I had to slam the brakes and I was really pissed off. Not even a minute later we drove past a cop. After we pass the cop he speeds up to 80 to 90 again. He must have been using a GPS that alerted him to police on the road, and he was nice enough to cut me off so I wouldn't get a speeding ticket. Was really awesome. Just this week I fell asleep on my morning commute and nearly missed my stop. All of us on the early express bus are technically strangers but know each other based on our unofficial assigned seats, ECT. Well, one guy rushed to wake me up. The other asked the bus driver to wait. The bus driver himself was like, "Doesn't someone get off here?" And when I nearly forgot my coat in my race to get off, they passed it forward. It was incredibly kind and considerate. I brought Kit Kats for them the next day in thanks. Reminds you that you have a village even when you don't know it. Edit 1, this was in the USA. Our bus starts at Port Authority in NYC and goes through Hackensack, New Jersey. Yes, we are all New Yorkers who reverse commute into Jersey for work. Edit 2. Thank you for the silver, kind strangers. Edit 3, oh man, gold. You're all great people and are now my Valentines. Have a great weekend. When I was in elementary I forgot I was getting picked up that day and hopped on the bus. I got home but didn't have a key so I sat outside, LA heat was bad. This lady slightly down the road saw me and let me go to her house for some snacks and juice and called my mom. Mom rushed in to find my dumb ass admiring the lady's glass chess pieces. I don't remember her that well, happened about 10 years ago, but I'll never forget what she did. Edit, oh my damn, my first silver. Thanks so much my guy. I'm male, 47. I was at the hospital because my 82-year-old mom, the core of our family, had just been diagnosed with a rare and advanced form of leukemia. She had perhaps weeks to live. My parents are immigrants to the US. We have no extended family, so it's just mom, dad, and us four kids. And mom was really the glue that held us together. So this news was devastating. Mom was quarantined in her room and sleeping. I, overwhelmed with grief and shock, was wandering through the halls of the hospital in a complete daze, utterly despondent. As I walked down a hall in one direction, an employee of the hospital, not a doctor or nurse because she was dressed in civilian clothes, but had a hospital employee badge on, was walking in the opposite direction. Without saying a word, she altered her course and stopped right in front of me. She didn't say anything. She just stopped me in my path. And she spread her arms. I collapsed in her arms and lost it. I hadn't cried like that in 40 years. Mom passed away 11 days later. That was 3 years ago, and I'm tearing up now just thinking about that woman's kindness. I carry that with me, to have that kind of decency to bestow the most intimate and basic of kindnesses to those most in need. Thank you, you are a hospital worker. You helped in ways I can't begin to express. When I was with my first wife and my daughter was only almost a year old, I had lost my job. We were getting toward the end of our savings. I went to the store to pick up a few groceries for the next few days, and as I went to go pay, a middle-aged woman came up and says, "Excuse me." She said, "I do not know why, but something is telling me I need to pay for your groceries." I couldn't believe it. Just about started crying, and I gave her a huge hug. I ran out of gas on a dirt road in New Mexico. No one around and miles from town. A guy picked me up, drove me to the gas station, and then all the way back out to my truck. He also refused money when I offered it and said, "Just make sure you help someone when they need it." Posted this somewhere, I don't know, but she pulled me to dance and kissed me on my 21st birthday. At the time I was feeling super depressed as I'd recently gotten out of a long, abusive relationship. She said I looked like I needed some love and wished me a happy birthday. Never met her in my life and never saw her since. When I was 9, a bee stung me right on my eyelid and my eye swelled shut and looked deep purple and disgusting. I was out to breakfast with my dad and some guy came up and gave me a dollar. Doesn't seem like much now, but back then it totally made my day. Was spending a summer in Vancouver. I was doing some food shopping with my girlfriend, but we both weren't sure if we'd been paid yet. Got to the till with all our stuff, $100 worth, and as you can expect, both our cards got declined. As I was apologizing to the cashier, a woman behind us walked right up and stuck her card in the machine. I tried to tell her there was no need, but she insisted, saying someone did something really nice for me today, and I'm just paying it forward. Was so stunned by this, tried to get her details to pay her back, but she just smiled, said it was nothing and went on her way. One of the kindest things anyone has ever done for me, thank you random Canadian lady. Thank you. I was traveling one time and full of anxiety. I had to catch a plane later that day, but had to take two trains to get to the city whence it was leaving. I was alone in a foreign country with no friendly faces. Then I overheard this one woman at the train stop where I was waiting, speaking a similar language to mine, and I sort of latched onto her the whole way to my next stop. When we got there, I didn't know where to go, so she helped me find the right platform. We were told that the departure of the train I was supposed to take had to be delayed. I freaked out, the woman helped me find the help desk and get the information I needed in case the train left too late for me to get to the airport on time. But not only that, she also gave me €250 in case I had to buy a new ticket. This woman was a complete stranger and she just handed me hundreds of dollars. The train ended up leaving like 10 minutes behind schedule, and I was so scared I wouldn't make it that I was reluctant to board, but she assured me it would be okay and convinced me to get on. The travel agency helped me out by contacting the airport and had them hold the plane for me. I made it onto the plane, but if it hadn't been for this woman, I might have ended up stranded in a big city, in a foreign country with no money. When I was working in customer service, on my break, this nomad lady actually came up to me and told me not to give up. It's not my time yet, but I will achieve what I want. It just hasn't aligned properly yet. Just don't give up. When having a rough day, I always remember her face and her words. Whatever force is out there, I wish her well. When I was 23 years old, I was about to walk into a sandwich shop and it was raining. I noticed out of my peripheral that there was a woman maybe 20 or so feet behind me. I held the door in the rain and she thanked me graciously. She went in line in front of me, ordered her sandwich and left. When I went to pay, she had paid for my sandwich without saying anything. I was eating gelato in Florence, peak tourist season, plus there was a heat wave, and I was kind of a mess. Just as I finish, some random shopkeeper offers me her hand and indicates for me to follow her. In my horrible Italian, I tell her no thank you and I don't speak Italian. She is adamant and so I figure I'll go. She leads me to this tiny bathroom, which she unlocked for me, and gestures for me to wash my hands. I cried. I'd been traveling alone in Europe for like 2 weeks, living out of my backpack and sleeping on couches and buses. It was such a simple act of kindness, but I will never forget it. Thank you for watching the video. Welcome to Reddit Wisdom. Here you will learn the wisdom of the crowd, the wisdom of Reddit. Please consider subscribing for more Reddit Wisdom.